The most common measurement of dispersion is in fact the variance in standard deviation. And actually the standard deviation is used much, much more than the variance, at least directly. One area that the standard deviation is used is it's part of the calculation for what's known as the margin of error. And we will deal a great deal with the margin of error much later. But in the time of like a political campaign, like a presidential election, you'll see polls all the time. And you may say that right now that, 51% of those surveyed said they're going to vote for candidate X. And then commonly in the lower right-hand corner of the screen, you see somewhere down here a margin of error. And you may say, see something like plus or minus 3%. Well, this idea of the margin of error, where it actually comes from, is based on, in part, the standard deviation. Standard deviation is a very key element of that margin of error calculation. So let's look at some symbols. It's extremely important that you understand the symbols that are used in this class. The variance, the parameter, is a Greek letter sigma squared, and the statistic we commonly use S squared. Some people use a capital S and some use a small. It really doesn't really matter. And it measures the variability. I'm going to say with respect to the mean. You could say relative to the mean or whatever. WRT is a common abbreviation for with respect to. The standard deviation, the parameter symbol for the standard deviation is simply sigma, and the statistic is S. Again, some people use a capital, some people use a lowercase s, doesn't really matter. And actually, it measures the exact same thing. And in reality, the standard deviation really is, I'm going to say standard deviation really is the square root of the variance. So the calculation, the equation is typically for the variance, and then simply take the square root of it, because sigma obviously is equal to sigma squared, just as s, I'm sorry, the square root of sigma squared, just as s is equal to the square root of s squared. So typically the calculation is for the variance, especially if you're doing it by hand, and then the last step would be to take the square root. Now, what do we mean when we say that it is measures a variability about the mean or with respect to the mean? Well, to actually discuss that, let's take a look at the calculation for the sample standard deviation. This is the formula that you would use if you're doing this by hand. Now, personally, I don't recommend you ever do this by hand, maybe once or twice in a small data set just to appreciate what's going on. But in reality, I think it's a much wiser to use technology. But it's a good idea to understand where these things come from, because hidden in here, actually not hidden, it's actually kind of staring in the face, is the reason that we say is variability about the mean, because right here in the middle of this calculation is the mean. Now this is a sample variance, and look what we're doing here. We're taking the xi's, which are the individual data point. Every individual data point, we're subtracting from it the mean. So this is going to be a distance. It's going to be the distance from the mean. Now it's important that we square it here, because we said before we looked at this idea. If we take a look at the sum of the xi's minus x bar, if we look at that sum, this will always be equal to 0. Within rounding, because of the numbers you're using, you may have a rounding error, but if you could take it out all the way out to the numbers actually end, then this would always be 0. So this would be totally useless. So that's why we square it, because anything that the, or any value such that the sample average is bigger than the observation is going to be negative, but when you square it, it becomes positive. Any value with the sample average is less than the observation, this could be positive. You square it, it's still positive. So we're adding up a bunch of positive numbers, and then we're dividing by n minus 1. Now this n minus 1, it's not really important you understand this now. This is actually referred to as the degrees of freedom. And this is an average of types of the squared distances from the mean, because this is a distance and I'm squaring it. So this is the sum of the squared distances from the mean, and then I'm dividing it by n minus 1. If we simply divided it by n, you would recognize that right away as being a type of average. The reason we divide by n minus 1, the degrees of freedom, really goes well beyond the level of this class, but has to do with bias and unbiased estimators. And this is actually an unbiased estimator for the variance. But anyway, this is the calculation. Now, if we're actually dealing with a population parameter, sigma squared, the hand calculation is very similar. It'll be the sum, n equals 1 to capital N. And actually, I guess I could, rather than an N, I could stay with I. Let me stay with an I here, so I'm kind of consistent with what I've done before. So I, there we go, equals 1 to capital N, which is a population size, xi, the observation, just like it was before, minus, only we're not going to be using x bar, we'll be using mu, the population mean. Well, if you have the population data and you calculate x bar, well, x bar is mu if you're dealing with the population. The calculation is the same, so it really won't make a difference. And that's also squared, and then we're dividing by n rather than n minus 1, where little n is a sample size. So you can see that most technology will give you both of these calculations. It's kind of obvious why. The technology doesn't know if you're using a population or a sample. So like in TC Stats, when we wrote that, we said, hey, we're going to produce both and provide both to the user. And the user should be smart enough to know if they're dealing with sample data or if they're using population data. So as an example here, take a look at the standard deviation and the variance for our data. Well, here is the the population standard deviation is right here, and the sample standard deviation is right here. Well, our data, we will consider it sample data. So we would use S equals 14.79535. So if we wanted to find the variance, what we really need to do is simply take that value, 14.79535, and square it. S squared, the variance, is 14.79535 squared, which gives me 218.02. My calculator went out this far, but typically I only go out four places. So if I was actually only going out four places, I would have rounded this off and said 9024. I would have reported that as the sample variance. Now, if this was the population, we'd have simply said sigma equals 14.54667, and sigma squared equals 14.54667 squared, whatever number that turns out to be. Just stick that in a calculator and find it. Now again, if you ever had to calculate this by hand, here's the equations that you would use. But like I said earlier, I'd hope that if you ever do it, you do it once or twice to get a feeling for what's going on and to appreciate the technology. But really, to me, it makes a lot more sense. Stick it in a calculator or TC Stats and let it do what it does best and crunch numbers for you. What's important is that once you get these numbers, that you know how to use it. And that's what we're going to start talking about next.